Now, I know it's only the second episode, but I'm going to be doing something completely different. Today's media is something written by a 7-year-old boy. Can you guess who that 7-year-old boy is? It's me. You see, an assignment we had to do in class once was write a little storybook. And this is the very first thing I have ever written. Pull up some covers and let me read you a bedtime story, for this is In the Day of the Dinosaurs. In the Day of the Dinosaurs, written and pictures by Sean P. Murphy. I was spying one some bad guys when one of them said, "Get him." It's going to be a little hard to get through. I ran and tripped offer a rock and fell into a blue hole. One of the brillets almost got me. I'm assuming that's bullets. And that's how I was in the age of the dinosaurs. Yeah, apparently I switched between past, present, and future tense in one sentence to the next. But anyway, I'm going to stop commenting on my 7-year-old self and actually continue reading the story. When I got there, I was next to a cave, and I throw rocks in the cave to make sure there was no dinosaurs. I got plants and wood to cover the cave so no dinosaurs could get in then. Oh, there should be a period there. Then Rex came and a Triceratops knocked him down. He fell with a big, all caps thud. Then I saw another blue hole, and out came the bad guys. I jumped behind a bush and said, "I dare you come behind here." "What?" said one of them. "It could be a trap." Then they shot holes everywhere. No one could live through that. Then my Kenthosaurus whacked thee into another blue hole over a volcano. So, somehow my characters were in front of a cave, and then apparently the cave was right next to the opening of a volcano, so you try to figure that one out. And apparently I befriended a made-up dinosaur. But I wonder where they are going to. Oh, you want to see some of the awesome art I designed here at 7? Look, there's a man, or I would suppose that's me, since it's in first person, jumping into a blue hole, the cave, and them, I guess, shooting through the foliage in the cave, and don't forget them falling into the portal in the volcano. I mean, alright, so, continuing on. Meanwhile, they were in the age of the pirates, walking the plank. "We're going to die." "Shut up," one of them said. I saw a blue hole and quickly jumped in it. "Why? The bad guys are gone. You're safe in dinosaur land." Whatever. Then I was in total darkness. I jumped in the same blue hole before it disappeared. Then I fell down in the pirate age and I hit the end of the plank. And me and the bad guys went flying in the air into the blue hole. Then I was in the bad guys' maze. They know the way, but I didn't. Help me get through the maze. Now, I haven't seen this book in 22, 23 years. And I distinctly remember going to my teacher saying, can I draw a maze in my book if it's incorporated into the story somehow? So, yeah, here's a maze in the middle of the story that you have to go through. Oh, but not just any maze. Oh, no, you're not going straight to the end. You see, you have to look for all the bombs. Yeah, I don't know why they were there either. You have to defuse all the bombs by just going to them. So basically, you have to go everywhere in the maze. And let's not forget, there's a code down here. I don't remember what my younger self was thinking to figure out how to answer this code to come up with 12 numbers from these 5 grids of 6. Was I just incredibly intelligent back then? Who knows? Anyway, I set off the bombs. Let's continue. I mean, stop the bombs. Whoa. When I got there, the cage fell on me, and they throw me in the blue hole. I was in the dinosaur's age, and they thought I was in the pirate age. I got the dinosaurs Brontosaurus, Triceratops, Apatosaurus, Dilophosaurus, Stegosaurus, and Kentosaurus. We went through... Now, how the hell... Okay, I was really into dinosaurs as a kid. As you can see, I didn't even need to think. I wrote and spelled every single one of these dinosaur names correctly, just from memory. Yet I can't learn how to spell bullet, thought, or simple words that are 4 letters long. It's like how people can remember all 150 Pokemon, but ask them if they can name all the presidents of the United States and see them draw a blank. We went through the blue hole and so rounded them while I called the police. Wayne? The police arrived. They said that I could be rich for people to see real-life dinosaurs. I got my camera and took pictures of them. Then I took pictures of the blue holes. sorry. Didn't think I was gonna make it there. Anyway, I led the dinosaurs back through the blue hole. When I took a picture of the blue hole, it was moving. I put my hand in it, picture of it. My hand went through, so now I can visit the dinosaur's age anytime. But I never told anyone that I was in the dinosaurs or when they came here. For one reason, no one would believe me. Oh yeah, and here's all the cool dinosaurs I organized. Yeah. And then here's the photograph of the blue hole. The end. So yeah, this is the first thing I ever wrote. I can't believe I even found this in the attic at my parents' place. But this inspired me, I think, because I remember from this point on, I was always creating in my head video games, movies, any kinds of comic books. Not too many books, though. Yeah, you can see where my priorities were. Since then, I've just had to go on creating everything. I mean, I've done interviews, done video game reviews, done some comedy skits online, I've done some short films, I've helped with an independent film and a TV pilot. I'm giving you like my resume here. I've even written some comic books that I've self-published, and I've got a novel that I'm also trying to self-publish. So I'm just all over the place. I can't stand to keep doing one thing for very long, because I need to start on the next thing, which is also cool. So yeah, that's the first thing I ever wrote. I wrote a lot more stuff since then, and definitely stuff that's a hell of a lot better than this. At least, I hope I have. Boom, boom, akalaka laka boom.
Miami Vice. I want the diamond.
So, yeah, sorry for this. Next episode, we'll continue our regular programs by continuing the second movie of Unico.